Hello, good morning students. Today we will start our the next lesson. See, in last lecture we have completed water lesson, okay, and you completed your worksheets also. So today we will start the next lesson, okay. That next lesson, see it, schedule number 5, the air. And so this lesson, it is given in your CBSE textbook, Air Around Us, related to lessons, whatever the point, extra point it is given in your state boards, that we will see in the next lecture, okay. So first we will complete our CBSE, in your CBSE textbook, whatever the points are given related to this lesson, that we will complete, and the remaining points we will complete after the completing this lecture. This lesson, okay. So now we will start the air around us. See, do you know that everyone know air is a present surrounded by us, but we cannot see air, okay, but we can feel air is a present, and it is, air is a mixture of a different gases. So many gases are present in our surrounding, okay. So air is a present everywhere. So for that you have to perform one activity. How we come to know that air is a present? Air we can feel it, okay, air is a present here. But in your textbook one activity it is given, okay. That is very simple activity. See here the picture, it is given. How to do this fan, okay. That all the procedure it is given in your textbook. Just you have to follow that procedure and make like this fan and just try to feel it, okay, and do this activity at home. Then you will know that, you will come to know air is present everywhere, okay. And see, air is present everywhere, okay, we feel air, but the moving air is called as a wind. See, moving air is called as a wind. Now wind, storm and all that you are learned last year also. So moving air is known as a wind, okay. So air present all around us, activity it is given in your textbook. And one more activity is given, that is air occupies space. Now see, in this classroom air is present, so air occupies this classroom whole space, okay. But how to prove that? How to prove the air is present in this classroom, okay. So for that one activity, one more very easy activity it is given in your textbook, okay. See here the pictures are shown. In this one container water is there, and this one glass, empty glass, okay. So what, empty glass, if you will see, the glass is empty, means water is not there, juice also, but in that what is present? You will say it is empty. No, because in empty glass also what is present? Air is present. So this glass also, in this glass also air is present. Now how to prove the air is present? For that activity is given. This empty glass, you just would have to do like this, then some air bubbles will come. See, it is shown in this diagram, air bubbles comes. That air bubbles means what? It proves the air is present in the glass, okay, and it comes in the form of bubbles. So this is also very simple activity, you can do at home also. So today what you have to do, just read this lesson, and this both the activities you have to do at home today itself. After completing your activity, you just have to inform me and write your observations. Whatever the observation, write down observation in your chemistry notebook, okay. And the next point it is given, that is the atmosphere. Now atmosphere, layers of the atmospheres, that diagram we have discussed in the 5th standard, okay, layers of atmosphere. So what is the exactly definition of atmosphere? See here, the blanket of air that surround the earth is called as a atmosphere, layers of atmosphere. If you have the 5th standard textbook, just open it and see the diagram. all the layers of atmosphere, that diagram you draw in your chemistry notebook, okay? So, and layers of this atmosphere means what? The blanket of air means blanket of air surrounded by the surrounds the earth is called as a atmosphere, okay? The air, it is a surround the earth, that is only known as a atmosphere. The diagram you draw in your chemistry notebook, okay? And the next point it is given, that is the composition of air means what? How many percentage of oxygen, nitrogen, that all we are going to learn in next lecture, okay? So today what you have to do, today first you read this lesson, then second one, this both the activities you have to do at home, very simple activities, write observation in your chemistry notebook and draw diagram of layers of atmosphere. It is given in 5th standard textbook, 5th standard of a CBSE textbook. So last year your textbook, just open it and draw that diagram in your chemistry notebook. When you completed this all the work, you have to inform me, okay? So today we will stop here. Tomorrow we will see our next point, that is the composition of air. So thank you.